Oh, excuse me, has anyone seen my arm? You can't miss it! It's green!
It has been about 3 months ever since we finally got Satisfaction. Directly after that movie, we haven't had Satisfaction since, but nevertheless, I was able to tell my father, the Pube Cookie Monster, that I finally got Satisfaction, and he told me that he was proud of me when we went to visit him that Monday morning and knows that he has a worthy successor to his title as the gayest Muppet alive. Anyways, we are finally starting out our adventures in Season 2, ladies and gentlemen, and you know what that means. It means more swell chances of gaining even more satisfaction, because I feel so fucking lucky. Yes! There will be no chances of Drew Pickles or his stupid Barney Bunch attempting to steal my satisfaction now! Hey, wait a minute, haven't any of you seen Pube Puppy? He's been acting awful strange. For example, he seems to have that worried look to his face, and he's been raping more male dogs than his maximum limit can handle, and he even fucked the dog catcher so hard that they passed out from anaphylaxis, or anaphylactic shock as it is called. Hopefully none of you think that my dog is sick. Anyone care to tell me what your thoughts are? Pubic family, what do you think that Pube Puppy is hiding behind his back that he doesn't want us to see? As your brother, I, Pube Jason, probably could guess that he's probably been raping female dogs behind our backs. I mean, come on, everyone has their darkest secrets, do they not? For example, let me share my darkest secret, although you may hurt me for it, but hey, your methods of pain are no threat to me because, like you, I love the swellness and fantasies of pain and vicious rape. I once met some prostitute, who I thought was a man, because she did look like one in my eyes. I was drunk that night, if that's any defense. After that I had to go to a therapist for what I've done, and I had to go to a homosexual church, and when I got to that church I raped everyone in there, even the minister, to death.
No, I don't think so, Pube Jason. If that was the case, I would have detected that with my homosexual frog sensors, but they're not going off on Pube Puppy. Good try though. Anyone else want to guess?
As your cousin, I, the Pube Nerd, think that he's some sort of super intelligent dog in disguise, and he's probably conducting some top secret experiment, but not just any top secret experiment, but a top secret experiment that involves building a gamma ray radiation that has the scent of female dogs in heat so that it can attract all of the male dogs around the world, and even in outer space, so that they come to our house so that not only he can rape all of the male dogs of the world, but also we can rape their tight assholes.
Ooh, bestiality sex is really, really swell. It's just a guess, though.
Pube Nerd, are you fucking kidding me?
He's not Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. He's a motherfucking dog, for God's sake.
What the fuck are you on? Drugs or medication or a new contact lens? If you're on drugs, tell me where you get it, because that must be some really insane shit you're using.
Dogs may be smart, but they're no more intelligent than a tree.
Just kidding, for people who own dogs. Anyways, nice try, but that's not even close to convincing. Anyone else?
As your sex slave, I, the Pube Beaker, think that probably he's really a sugar daddy to young male dogs, and that he's making enormous lots of money for wearing out his male dogs, but hey, what do I know? He could have some sort of affair with a female dog, as was mentioned earlier, and your homosexual frog sensors may be way off. Oh well, I tried.
No comment there, Pube Beaker. Maybe if Seltzer wasn't starting to get lazy, then maybe I would have a comment. From this point forward, I will only say something to the person who seems to be the closest to the answer. I know what he's hiding, but I want you, my pubic family, to guess.
As your personal chef and creator of homosexual foods, I, the Pube Swedish chef, thinks that he has a letter from Drew Pickles. There's a reason why I say it, though. It's because I think he's hiding the letter so he won't have to worry about it, and the other reason is because I think Pube Puppy wants to try to take care of this problem without our help, but yet, he knows he can't do it alone. Is that even close to the answer, or should I just say my original theory? Oh, for the hell of it, why not? Here's my original theory. My guess is that Pube Puppy is busy stripping all of the male dog shit from the streets, the dog parks, and everywhere where you may find dogs, and while he's at it, raping the male dogs.
Actually, Pube Swedish Chef's answer seems to be more at your end.
Well, speak of the devil himself. It's Pube Puppy.
Hey, Pube Puppy, what's the deal with a letter? Let me see that and read it out loud. Okay, here's what it says. Hello there, Pube Muppet and Company. Some people call me the Guru of Satisfaction. But you, feel free to call me the Homo Agent 181. From this point until the third season, I vow to be your guide and lead you to the correct way of getting satisfaction, seeing as how you've always failed. I promise you, my plans are foolproof, however, nothing comes without a price. You may be thinking money, but no, that isn't what I require of you. If you want a demonstration, simply bring Drew Pickles along with you in your next video. And he might think twice about randomly trying to steal your satisfaction. Same thing with Barney Bunch, they just might suffer too. You shall know what I want by the time of the fifth episode, if not sooner. I am also omnipotent, I can tell you if anyone's trying to disguise themselves just to rob you of your satisfaction. Goodbye, and if you agree to this deal, hit the CENTER button. Huh.
This sounds suspicious, but oh what the hell? I'll accept, as long as it gets me satisfaction. Drew Pickles won't even be able to stop me with this homo agent's help.
And everything is going to the beat. And everything is going to the beat. And everything is going to...